Hello students, welcome to Pi Academy, the place for mathematics and science. Dear students, in yesterday's class we finished the first chapter in mathematics, that is real numbers, right? And do remember, in today's class we are going to finish the first chapter in science, that is electricity. And today is 10th period of this chapter. In the chapter electricity, we were in the last part. That is, we were answering for exercise questions. Total 6 were over. Now, I have written 2 more questions here. Let's go for answering them. Before that, first you read 7th one. Look here. Let me go for reading the 7th question. The values of current I flowing in a given resistor for the corresponding values of potential difference V across the resistor are given below. Look at here, table has been given in that current and voltage. Next, for with respect to this, plot a graph between V and I. This is one sub question, and calculate the resistance of the resistor. This is the question. Let's go for answering. Before that, first we must understand the given statement. Once you go through that, current I is flowing corresponding to the potential difference V. What is the meaning of that? Whether we are taking the readings of I with respect to V or V with respect to I? It is I with respect to V. That means we are changing the voltage. According to that voltage, that whatever the current is recorded, that will be written in the table. You can notice that. Look here, for voltage 1.6, 0.5 is there. And for voltage 3.4 volts, current it will be 1 amp. Like that, all are written. Next, plot a graph between V and I. To draw the graph, we need x and y axis, right? If it is so, what should be taken along x axis? What should be taken along y axis? We know that we always take the independent quantity along x axis. Dependent quantity or variable quantity along y axis, right? If so, in which of these two, I and V, is independent? Yes. Can you say that? Voltage? Yes. How do you think? Yes. It is because we are taking the ammeter reading by changing the voltage. So voltage is constant. Hence I go for taking voltage along x axis and current along y axis. Clear up? So now let us go for drawing the graph. So you have to take the graph sheet and should use scale and pencil, and you should draw in this way. Now I am going to explain it. Look here, in this graph, you can come to know that voltage is taken along x axis and current is taken along y axis. And when you observe those values, you can come to know that in voltage rho, 1.6, 3.4, 6.7, 10.2, 13.2 is there, up to 13.2. Hence, in scale, we can take 1 centimeter equal to 1 voltage. So, you can go for marking up to 14. Whereas, current is to be taken along y-axis. Here, 0.5, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, 4.0 amps. So, just we can go for taking 1 centimeter equal to 1 amp or 0.5 amp is equal to 1 centimeter. So, here I have done the same. Just look here. You just go through this graph. Here in voltage, along x axis we have taken voltage, then scale has been written, 1 centimeter equal to 1 volt, total 15 markings are there, right? Then next, go through y axis. In y axis, 1 centimeter equal to 0.5, see that, 0.5, 1.0, 1.5, 2.0, 2.5, 3.0, 3.5, 4.0 and 4.5. And we have to go for marking. In the first column,
When voltage is 1.6, current is 0.5 amps. When voltage is 1.6, see that it comes in between 1 and 2. 1.6, more than half of. Here, 1.6. And just I'm going to draw the dotted line. Then current will be 1.5 amps. So here a dot is there and it is encircled. Next, for voltage 3.4, current 1 ampere. 3.4, see that 3.4, it has been marked here. Like this, you should go on marking all the values. Okay. After that, you just go for joining the points, you will get a straight line. In Ohm's law only, we have already learned that the graph of V and I, or I and V, it is straight line that represents it is constant, is it not? And using this graph, we have to find out the resistance. Look here particularly they have not asked whether you have to use the graph for finding resistance or not. But in general, how do you go for finding the resistance? First, I will go for finding the resistance by using the formula directly. Here, resistance, it is R is equal to V by I. It is according to Ohm's law, right? Here I will write, by Ohm's law. Then voltage, you can go for taking any one. These many are there. And current, these many are there. I go for taking the voltage 1.6 volts. What about current? Its corresponding current is 0.5. This can be written as 16 by 5. You just go for cancelling. You will get 5 ones are 5, 3s are 15. 1 will remain 10, 5 2s are. So R is 3.2 ohm. It is resistance has been calculated using the formula. But how do you go for finding the resistance using the graph? Let me explain. Resistance from graph. Usually we go for taking the slope to find out the resistance. Look here. Here I will just go for marking two points A and B. Then draw a perpendicular line from B and a horizontal line from A. And these two will intersect at a point, call it as C. So how do you go for finding the slope? We know that slope is nothing but the ratio of vertical distance to the horizontal distance. Vertical distance is BC, horizontal distance is AC. Clear up? Even in graph also, we have to take the same. Observe it. Here, the graph is there. You can go for taking any two points, anywhere else. Here AB, then PQ, whatever you want, you can take. Observe. This is P. This is P and it is Q. From P, we have drawn a line parallel to x-axis, and from Q, we have drawn a line parallel perpendicular to x-axis. The point of intersection is represented as R. Clear? Okay, now let us go for finding the slope of PQ. Here I will write. It is from the graph. Slope of PQ. In that I have marked like this. This point is taken as P and this has been taken as Q. And this point is R. Slope of PQ can be written as QR by PR. Vertical distance by horizontal distance. It is QR by PR. Then how do you go for taking the values of QR and PR? See that you want QR value, this value. From here to here, how much is there? You see that. And from here to here, subtract this distance from the whole distance. I'll show that. Observe this graph again. In this graph, look here. Here, we want QR. QR, it is
4.0, and up to her ear, this distance, it is 0.5. So 4.0 from here to here, then 0.5 from here to here. Okay, 4.0 minus 0.5.
4.0 minus 0.5 divided by PR.
Again, you just observe. Look here, PR. This is PR from P to R here. Now, at R, it is 13, right? Then up to P, it is 13.2 up to R, and this is 1.6. You can observe that from here to here 13.2, from here to here it is 1.6. 13.2 minus 1.6.
13.2 minus 1.6. Now this is equal to here 4.0 minus 0.5, it is 3.5. Now 13.2 minus 1.6, subtract that. 13.2 minus 1.6, 12 minus 6, 6. 1 will remain. 1 minus 1, 0, it is 1. 10.6. 10.6. Got it? Here, what has been taken? 3.5, it is current. And this is voltage. This is current and this is voltage. Understood? Then can we take this as 1 by R? Because we all know that R is equal to V by I. If it is I by V, it is 1 by R. Clear? Now, let me go for finding value of R. So now, it is R is equal to, go for cross multiplication, 10.6 divided by 3.5. Now, this is equal to, remove the decimal, it is 106 and here 35. After decimal, one digit, and here also after decimal, one digit. So, it doesn't make any such a difference. Now, divide 106 by 35. 106 by 35. 35, 3 is a 105. 1 will remain. Put decimal, take 0. Then take one more 0. It is 35. 2 is a. So we can write 3.2. Okay. It is 3.2 ohm. Clear? And do remember this 3.2 ohm, it is by using Ohm's law. And here, resistance has been found by using the graph. Understood? Okay. So now we have answered for both. We have drawn the graph. I have already shown you how to draw that. Next, we have calculated resistance. Now, let's move on to second question. Observe this. Please don't write anything. Now, eighth one is, when a 12-volt battery is connected across an unknown resistor, we do not know what is that resistance, there is a current of 2.5 milliamps in the circuit. Find the value of the resistance. Very simple. Look at voltage, current. You are going to find out resistance. So, there is a relationship among these three. And before going to that, first let me write data. Here, 12 volt. 12 volt it is voltage. Then, there is a current of 2.5 milliamps. We know that. What is the value of the prefix milli? It is 10 raised to the power minus 3. So, 2.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 amps. Next, you are going to find out R. The relationship among these three physical quantities can be expressed by using Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, how do you go for writing? Yes, it is R equal to V by I, which is equal to, where V is 12 and I is 2.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 3. Now, this is equal to it is 12 into, take 10 raised to the power minus 3 to the numerator, it becomes 10 raised to the power plus 3 divided by 2.5. Clear? It is equal to, observe, in the denominator after decimal one digit is there. To convert this into whole number, you can take 10 in the numerator, it will be 120, and this will be, denominator will be 25. Into 10 raised to the power 3, 10 raised to the power 3 is nothing but 1000. 120 into 1000, it is 120,000. Clear? Or else if you want to make the calculation still simpler, you can write 1000 as it is, which is the value of 10 cube, and go for cancel. 25 ones are, 25 fours are 100, zeros are. Next, it is 120 into 40, 1010, two zeros, 12 fours are 48, 4800 ohm. So therefore, the value of the unknown resistor is 4800 ohm. Clear? Here, therefore, the resistance of unknown resistor is 4800 ohm. Clear? Yeah. Now, without wasting your time, pause the video and copy from there to here and use the graph sheet and draw the graph using scale and pencil. Yes, copy. Dear students, here we have two more questions. They are also very important. Statements are also very nice. Let's go through one by one. It is 9th one. Observe this. A battery of 9 volt is connected in series with resistors 0.2 ohm, 0.3 ohm, 0.4 ohm, 0.5 ohm and 12 ohm respectively. How much current would flow through the 12 ohm resistor? Did you understand? Could you tell how many resistors are there? Yes, there are 5 resistors. How they are connected? They are connected in series. Just for the sake of information, I am drawing this 1, 2, 3, 4th resistor and this is 5th resistor. A 9 volt battery is connected along with these 5 resistors. This is 9 volt battery. And now, it is, think that 0.2 ohm, this is 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 and this is 12 ohm. I am highlighting 12 ohm because you are going to find out the amount of current that flow through the 12 ohm resistor, right? Dear students, we have already learned that in case of series connection, once the current is constituted in the circuit, once the current is developed in the circuit, the same amount of current flows through all the resistors, right? Now let us go for finding the current. To find out the current, we need voltage as well as resistance. Voltage is known, 9 volt. What about the resistance? It is, total resistance is not given. Let's go for finding that. Here first I'll write a data. Look here. It is voltage, 9 volt battery is given. Next, 5 resistors. I am going for calculation directly. You are going to find out I. Now, to find out I, first you must know the total resistance or effective resistance. R equal to, that is equivalent resistance. It is R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5. Reason, the resistors are connected in series. I am writing it directly. It is 0.2 ohm plus 0.3 ohm plus 0.4 ohm plus 0.5 ohm plus it is 12 ohm. Altogether, how much it will be? It is 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 2, 14. So it is 1.4, 1.4 plus 12, it is 13.4 ohm. This is equivalent resistance of the resistors connected in series. Clear? In bracket you can write because they are in series connection. Next, you are going to find out the amount of current to flow through 12 ohm. Again, I am reminding you one important point. Once the current is constituted in the circuit, the same amount of current flows through all the resistors if the resistors are connected in series. So let's go for finding the amount of current flowing in the circuit. So by Ohm's law, according to Ohm's law, you can write R is equal to V by I. Then what about I? I is equal to V by R. This is equal to what is voltage? It is 9. And resistance, equivalent resistance, just we have found out it is 13.4. Here, after decimal, one digit is there, it becomes 90. And it is 134. 13.4 is there, it becomes 134. Again, I am going to continue here. It is equal to, cancel it by 2. 2 45s are 90. Then 2, 6 are 12. 1 will remain 47. 45 by 7, 67. Let us go for dividing 45 by 67. 450. 67, how much are? 6 are 36, 7 6 are 42. Yes, 6 are. 67, 6 are. 6 sevens are 42, 4. 6 6 are 36 plus 4. 40. 10 minus 2. 8, here 4 will remain. 48. Take one more 0. Now you can go for 7. So after decimal, 2 digits are enough. It is 0.67. Dear students, please do remember 0.67 ohm, sorry, 0.67 ampere. This much amount of current flows through R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. Now, could you tell what amount of current flows through 12 ohm? Yes, it is 0.67. Clear? So, here I'll write. Therefore, current flows through 12 ohm is, therefore, the current flows through 12 ohm is 0.67 amps. Got it? Yes. Now, let's move on to 10th one. 10th one is also very nice and is also important in the examination point of view. Let's go through this. 10th one. How many 176 ohm resistors which are to be connected in parallel are required to carry 5 amps of current on a 220 volt line? Did you understand? Here we do not know what number of resistors required each of 176 ohm to carry this much amount of current with a in the potential difference of 220 volt. How do you go for finding this? And do remember, they only have given, they are to be connected in parallel. Here, first let us write the data. 176 ohm, what does it indicate? It indicates the resistance of each resistor. Resistance of each resistor, that is equal to 176 ohm. Next, they are to be connected in the line of potential difference 220 volt to draw the current of 5 amps. So, I is equal to 5 amps. Then voltage V is equal to 220 volts. Let's go for calculation. Here only I'll write. Observe it. First, we should come to know if 5 amount of electric current has to be drawn in a circuit whose potential difference 220 volt. How much electric resistance it can offer, we do not know that. First let's go for finding that. Got it? Resistance offered in the circuit, resistance in the circuit is given by, how do you write? Yes, it is R equal to V by I. Then this is equal to, what is the voltage? 220. Current, it is 5. It is equal to 5 ones are, then it is 5 fours are 20. 2 will remain 20. 5 fours are. R equal to 44 ohm. This is the resistance offered in the circuit. Then you may be thinking that when number of 176 ohm resistors are connected in parallel, they should also offer the same resistance, right? But we do not know how many resistors required to offer this much of resistance. Let us go for assuming that here I'll write its continuation. Let the number of resistors be X. Got it? Now you tell that what is the resistance of equivalent resistance of those resistors, X number of resistors connected in parallel. There are, we do not know what number of resistors are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they are all connected in parallel. X number of resistors are there. Equivalent resistance, as they are connected in parallel, we can write like this, 1 by Rp. This is equivalent resistance of resistor. I'll write equivalent resistance of X number of resistors is given by 1 by Rp is equal to, how many are there? 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 plus so on. How many? We do not know. X number of resistors are there. What is the resistance of each resistor? 176. So you can write 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176, 1 by 176 and so on. How many resistors? There are X number of resistors are there. Then 1 by Rp, can it be written as, here look at 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, how many times? X time. So I can write X into 1 by 176. Hope that you all have understood this. And here let us go for finding Rp. Rp is equal to 176 by X. 176 by X, that's equal to Rp. Look here. We do not know how many resistors are there, but the total resistance offered by the number of resistors, that should be equal to the resistance offered in the circuit to draw a current of 5 amps in 220 volt difference, potential difference. Now I go for equating these two. R equal to Rp. Then reason, resistance offered by the circuit equal to resistance, equivalent resistance of X number of resistors. R equal to 44 and Rp equal to 176 by X. Go for cross multiplication. X equal to 176 by 44. Here I'll continue. It is equal to, you can go for cancelling. Will it be cancelled by 11? Yes. Look at 44, here it is there. 11, 4s are 44. 11, 1s are 11. 6 will remain 66. 11, 6 are 16 by 4. It is 4. X equal to 4. Did you understand? So we need 4 such resistors. Therefore, the number of resistors each having 176 ohm is 4. The number of resistors required is 4. Did you understand? You can go for checking. See that you have to take 4 resistors. 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176. 1 by RP. This is equal to. Then this is 176. 4. Just go for finding that. You shall we check it out? Look here. This is 1 by RP is equal to this much. We want RP. RP is equal to 176 by 4. Now 4 ones are 4 4s are 16. 1 will remain 4 4s are. See that 44. 44 ohm. It is just for verification. Clear? Yeah. Hope that you have understood. Please understand and write. Pause the video, copy from there to here. Yes, quickly. Yes. Now I have taken 2 more questions. These 2 questions are also very nice. And it is one of the expected one. Observe. Show how you would connect 3 resistors. Each of resistance 6 ohm. The combination has a resistance of 9 ohm and 4 ohm. Look here. There are 3 resistors. 6 ohm, 6 ohm, 6 ohm. If you go for just connecting them in series, it will be 18 ohm. Obviously, it cannot be connected in series. And if you go for finding the equivalent resistance by connecting them in parallel, it will be less than 6. Right? But we want less than 6, it may be 4 also. Let us check that later. First, 9 ohm. So, keeping 6 ohm as it is, let's go for connecting these 2 parallel. Clear up? For first one, I go for drawing like this. Only for the sake of information, this is 6 ohm and remaining 2 are connected in parallel in this way. It is also 6 ohm, 6 ohm. Observe. Here, when you find out the equivalent resistance by connecting the resistors in mixed combination, you should get 9 ohm. Already 6 is there. We want equivalent resistance of these 2. Here I write solution for first one. Here equivalent resistance of resistors connected in parallel. I take this as 1 by RP. It is equal to these 2. 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. It is equal to. Then it is LCM is 6. This will be 2. Right? Because denominator terms are same. You can just go for adding numerator term. It is 1 by 3. 2 1s are 2 3s are. 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 3. RP equal to 3 ohm. And look here. This is its equivalent resistance is 3 ohm. And this equivalent resistance is connected in series with the 6 ohm. Hence, I write the equivalent resistance RS is equal to the 6 ohm plus 3 ohm. How much it is? 9 ohm. Clear? So they have asked, show how you would connect 3 resistors. Each of resistors 6 ohm, the combination has a resistance 9 ohm. So here we have shown that with the circuit diagram, and for justification even we have calculated. So first 2, you can go for taking first 2 resistors in parallel, then that should be connected in series. I go for second one. Observe. Second one is, we have to get 4 ohm. When you go for taking, it is just by trial and error method. If you go for connecting them in parallel, see that 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. Then it will be 3 by 6. It will be 1 by 2. Just we get 2 ohm only. But we want 4 ohm. So parallel connection is not possible, series connection is not possible, and this type connection is also not possible. What is the rest? Here, two are in parallel, then connected in series. Now, let us go for taking its reverse. Two are in series, and one is in parallel. Got it? Let's go for trying this one. Observe. Here, what is the equivalent resistance of these two? Rs is equal to 6 plus 6. It is 12 ohm. Then, and this equivalent resistance is in parallel with 6 ohm. Hence, I go for taking 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by 12 plus this 1 by 6. Here I'll write. It is equal to 1 by Rp equal to LCM is 12. Then multiply LCM with first term. 12, 12 get cancelled. 1. Multiply LCM with second term. 6, 1, 2, 7. It is 3 by 4. Right? 3 by 12, cancel it. 1 is 4. So 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by 4. So Rp is equal to 4 ohm. Understood? Yeah. You can go for answering in this way. We have shown how they are to be connected. We have given even the justification. If you want to tell that in words how they are connected, you can tell like this. The first two resistors are connected in series and which are in parallel with the third resistor to get the equivalent resistance 4 ohm. Followed? Okay. Now, we will move on to another one. 12th one. The statement is also very nice. Please observe that. 12th one. Several electric bulbs designed to be used on a 220 volt electric supply line are rated 10 watt. How many lamps can be connected in parallel with each other across the two wires of 220 volt line if the maximum allowable current is 5 amps? Got it? It is just like the previous one, that is, I think, 10th question. In 10th, some resistors were connected in parallel, but how many resistors were required? That was unknown and we found out that. This problem resembles the previous one. Let's go for answering in the same way. Okay. Here, several electric bulbs designed to be used on a 220 volt electric supply line are rated 10 watt. We do not know how many electric bulbs required, and but they have given their rate is about 10 watt. It indicates the power of each bulb is 10 watt. I'll write the same. Let the number of electric bulbs, that is equal to x. We do not know that x number of electric bulbs are there. Then power of each bulb, this is equal to 10 watt. How many lamps can be connected in parallel with each other? How many lamps can be connected in parallel? Means which can be operated separately if they are connected in parallel. We do not know how many such electrical lamps are required with each other across the two wires of 220 volt line if the maximum allowable current is 5 amps. So 220 volt, it is the voltage. Here I will write V is equal to 220 volts and I equal to 5 amps. Got it? But we do not know what is the resistance offered by that circuit. They have given here, it draws a current of 5 amps with a potential difference of 220 volt. So first we have to find out the resistance offered by the circuit then the resistance offered by those number of electric lamps. So both should be, obviously both should be equal. So let's go for calculation. Here I'll write in the same way, resistance offered by the circuit, that can be written as, according to Ohm's law, how do you write? R is equal to V by I. What is the voltage? 220. And the amount of current flows, it is 5. Then R is equal to, cancel it, 5 4s are 20. Again, 2 will remain, becomes 20. 5 4s are. It is the total resistance offered by the circuit. Next. Then how many number of bulbs are there? It is unknown. We have taken X. What is the resistance of each bulb? We do not know that one. Hence, we have to find out the resistance of each bulb. Here I write. Resistance of each bulb. How do you go for writing? Yes. We know that the power of bulb is 10 watt and it is to be connected in the line of 220 volt voltage, right? Look here, power is known, voltage is known, what do you need? It is resistance, right? What is the relationship among these three? To get that, you just go for recalling the power formulas. P equal to W by T, P equal to E by T, P equal to V into I, P equal to I square R, P equal to V square by R. Which one you will go for taking? Yes. P is equal to V square by R. Clear? Okay. Now we want R. R is equal to V square by P. What is V? Voltage is, they have already given, 220. V square is there. I write 220 again. Divided by the power. What is the power of each bulb? 10. 0, 0 get cancelled. 220 into 22. Here 0. 22, 22 is a 484. This is the resistance of each bulb. I hope that you have understood. Then how many bulbs are there? There are X number of bulbs are there. Then what is the resistance of, equivalent resistance of these bulbs? Do you write, if resistance of one bulb is 4840, X number equal to 4840 into X? It cannot be, because the resistors are, sorry, the lamps are to be connected in parallel. Now, let's go further. This is the resistance of each bulb. When the resistor, when the bulbs are connected in parallel, when bulbs are connected in parallel, then 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 4840 plus 1 by 4840 and so on. How many bulbs are there? X. So how do you write? It is 1 by 4840 into X. Can we write so? Yes. Then in that, find out RP. So RP is equal to, cross multiply, 4840 divided by X. Reciprocal of 1 by RP is RP. Reciprocal of this is 4840 by X. This is the equivalent resistance of bulbs connected in parallel, X number of bulbs connected in parallel. Obviously, this much amount of resistance is also offered in the circuit. What is the resistance offered in the circuit? It is 44 ohm. Both will be equal. Here I'll write. It is R is equal to RP. R is 44 ohm. This is equal to 4840 by X. Go for cross multiplication. X equal to 4840 by 44. Then go for cancelling them by 2. 2 whether it comes by Laban.
Yes,
Laban 4s are 44. Then Laban 4s are 44. 4 will remain 44. Laban 4s are 44. Then 0. Cancel it by 4. 1s are 0s are. X equal to 110. Now could you tell how many bulbs are required? Yes, 110 bulbs are required. Here on right, how many lamps can be connected in parallel? So therefore, the number of lamps connected to be connected, number of lamps to be connected in parallel is 110. Got it?
Yes.
Dear students, I hope that you have understood. You have to copy this. And 11th one, it is up to here, then 12th one from here to here. Please understand and write. So pause the video, copy from there to here quickly. Go through 13th one. This is a hard plate of an electric oven connected to a 220 volt line has two resistance coils. What are those? A and B. Each of 24 ohm, that is the resistance, which may be used separately in series or in parallel. If so, what are the currents in the three cases? Did you understand what are three cases? Here they are given two coils. They are named those coils as A and B. They are connected in the line which is maintaining potential difference of 220 volt. And the resistance of each coil is 24 ohm. And there are three ways. If they are used separately, coil A in one circuit, coil B in another circuit, lighter. And if they are used together in series, if they are used together in parallel, then what amount of current flows, that should be found out in these three cases. Let's go for answering this. First, let me write data. How many coils are there? There are two coils and they are named as A and B. Number of coils, it is 2. They are A and B. Next, they are to be connected in 220 volt line supply. That is the voltage. V is equal to 220 volts. Calculation. Observe. Let's go for writing directly. Okay. When A and B are used separately, and even they are given the resistance of each coil is 24 ohm, which is R equal to 24 ohm. Here I will write case 1. What is the first case? It is when the coils A and B are used separately. This is the first case. What amount of current it draws? Dear students, we know that A and B, these are the two coils whose resistance is same. Hence, the amount of current drawn by the coil A obviously equal to the amount of current drawn by coil B. Now, voltage is known, resistance of the coil is known. Then you are going to find out current. To find out that, we can go for using Ohm's law. By Ohm's law, you can write R is equal to V by I. R equal to V by I. But we want current. I equal to V by R. You can write this formula directly. It is equal to, what is the voltage? 220. And the resistance? 24. Next, this is equal to, it can be cancelled by 4. 4, 6 are 24, 4, 5 are 22, will remain again 25. Cancel it by 6. Now, 6 9s are 54, 1 will remain, it becomes 10. 6 1s are 6, 4 will remain 40. 6 6 are 36. After decimal, 2 digits are enough. So, current drawn by each coin is 9.16 amps. Clear? Now, let's move on to second case. Case 2. Observe. What is that? If the resistors, those coils are to be connected in series. Here I'll write. When the coils A and B are connected in series, obviously the resistance will be changed, right? It will not be just only 24, because two coils are there, they are to be connected in series. When they are connected in series, effective resistance will be sum of the resistance of those coils. Here I'll write RS is equal to R1 plus R2, that is 24 plus 24. Hope that you have understood. RS, you can write resistance of coil A plus resistance of coil B. That is equal to 24 plus 24, which is equal to 48 ohm. But we want the current. Current, again we can go for using the same formula. Current drawn by these coils when they are connected in series. I is equal to, it is V by R. I need space for calculating the third case, hence I go for writing horizontal. Where voltage, there is no difference in the voltage. 220 by R is 48. Even this is also to be divided by 4. 1s are 2s are, here 5s are 5s are. 55 by 12, it is equal to, then go for cancelling, 12 4s are 48, right? 7 will remain 70. 12 5s are 60, 10 will remain, it becomes 100. 12 8s are 96, after decimal, 2 digits are enough. So 4.58 amps, this much amount of electric current drawn. Next, case 3. In the third case, how they are to be connected? They are to be connected in parallel coils. Here I'll write, when the coils, that is A and B, are connected in parallel. If they are connected in parallel, what is the effective resistance? It is reciprocal of effective resistance is equal to, it is sum of reciprocal of individual resistance, 1 by RA, that is resistance of coil A, 1 by RB, which is equal to, 1 by RB is equal to 1 by 24 plus 1 by 24. It is equal to, LCM is 24, because same terms are there, add just numerator terms. Now it is 2, 1 by 12, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 12, RP equal to 12 ohm. Yeah, this is the resistance offered by the two coils when they are connected in parallel. Next, we want what amount of current they draw if they are connected in parallel. Again, by Ohm's law, we can write directly to find out the current as I equal to V by RP. V by, what is the voltage? It is 220 and resistance is 12. Go for cancelling. 2 6 are, 2 1s are, 1s are, 0s are. It is equal to 6 1s are 6, 5 will remain, it becomes 50. 6 8s are 48, 2 will remain 20. 6 3s are 18, 2 will remain, again 3s are 18.33 amps. Very simple to understand. You know that when the coils are connected in series, resistance obviously increases, current decreases, right? And when the coils are connected in parallel, then effective resistance decreases, as a result of it current increases. You can notice that. Okay, current drawn by the resistors connected in coils connected in series 4.58. next, current flows, it will be 18.33 amps when they are connected in parallel. Got it? Yes. Go for copying from there to here. Dear students, still we have 5 more questions. They are also important, and today we took more time for explanation, and tomorrow this chapter will be completed. Okay, so with this, let us stop the class. Thank you.